adaptation of the famous work by the writer from Dominica called Jean Reeves. The book is White Sargasso Sea. So it's a movie whose mystery and treatment, respectful treatment of Caribbean culture, and particularly the religion of voodoo, as it's more popularly called, really has had an impact on the imagination of Caribbean and Latin American writers. What I like most about this movie is, first of all, how it returns to the roots of Jane Eyre. So you will see that the movie recreates the story of Jane Eyre in a Caribbean setting. This is not surprising, since the mad woman in the attic of Jane Eyre is a Jamaican. So the combination of themes that Jane Eyre was dealing with when she was she actually made her anti-heroine, the woman in the attic, a Caribbean heiress, connects that film with the whole history of slavery, the plantation, cane fields, and sugar production. And in a way, what this very imaginative rendition of the return of Jane Eyre to the Caribbean setting, which later would be recreated in her novel White Sargasso Sea by Jean Reeves, is really an inversion, a kind of invitation to look at that 19th century classic as having had roots in the Caribbean, as being intricately linked with the history of the Caribbean. One of the things I like most about this movie, and it's one of the reasons I've written about it and have included very often in my classes, is that we don't get this kind of respectful treatment of the religion of voodoo, particularly in 1943. So why the fascination with zombies? Why is it that we have a beginning in the 30s, the beginnings of a genre that has become so iconic in American film, right? We all know zombie films. We all know the complex transformation of the zombie film. So what is a zombie? Zombies exist. And actually the first person to look at what really is a zombie was American anthropologist and writer Zora Neale Hurston. In Haiti, the practices of voodoo are very simple. They're not connected with dark Saturnalia and horror. It is a very sustaining religion, and it's practiced by most people in Haiti. Haitians are fond of saying that Haiti is 95% Catholic and 100% voodoo, because people practice it a lot. Voodoo is a religion of the here and now. It doesn't deal with the afterworld. And it's a kind of sustaining force. You pray to the Loi, you pray to the spirit, and you pray to God. It's all on the same plane. But zombification is really a fascinating aspect of voodoo. And it's actually a practice not of voodoo itself, but really of secret societies known as the Vizango. And what it is a form of punishment. It is a quintessential form of punishment, a sort of capital, sentence if you've done something truly horrible and the law cannot reach you. So if you do something really, really bad in your small community, the society might get together, ask you to reconsider, and if you are recalcitrant, they may pass judgment on zombification. It is done by a potion, its powers that are absorbed through the skin. Essentially paralyzes you temporarily. There is an antidote, and it is not a death sentence. What it is, if you believe in voodoo, if you practice voodoo, it means, and this is why I love this recreation here, it means that the boko, or priest, will actually siphon out your petit bonage, the part of your soul that commands, gives you willpower. So essentially, it removes your willpower. If you don't believe in voodoo, you may have a very traumatic experience and recover or not. If if you practice voodoo, you will be seriously concerned about your ability to continue to live the life that that you had before. But what happens in this movie is that it is one of the first serious treatments of voodoo and Caribbean culture in general in a film, particularly surprising because zombie movies have their roots in the occupation of Haiti by American troops between 1915 and 1934. And what is produced during those years in terms of books, this movie itself is part of, it becomes out of a series of articles written by Inez Wallace about Haiti, is that the connection, that the that confrontation with the mysteries and the religious practices of Haiti becomes sensationalized in books like Magic Island and other books that were pretty popular in the 30s and 40s. So what we have here is a film where one of the writers, one of the screenwriters, has reported that Val wanted us to get every book on voodoo practices that we could. He wanted to make it authentic. He wanted the bata drums. He wanted drums that had been blessed, that had inya, that had been given a soul to play the music in the film. He wanted the representation to be respectful. He wanted the music to be real. So he really, what we have here is not perfect, it's a little bit sensationalized, but not quite what we would have expected of the kind of climate that these books had brought to the United States in terms of what people thought about Haiti and its practices at that time. The other thing is that what we have here is not Haiti. It's a kind of hybrid Caribbean with Sir Lancelot, a Calypsonian, providing a kind of Greek chorus. He tells us the story, he comments on the story, he sets it off for us. Sir Lancelot, however, was a Trinidadian. Calypso is not Haitian music, it's Trinidadian music. So what we have here is an imagination of the Caribbean that returns us to the roots of Jane Eyre, but brings tries to bring to life in a kind of genuine way religious practices and an evocative, atmosphere that came out of that research that was done by the scriptwriters. The other thing that I can't wait to see because it's so beautiful in the screen, the small screen, is the photography, the splendid photography, the place of light and shadow, the filtering of light, use of grills and blinds, to bring light in particularly evocative ways. I can't wait to see. I can't wait to see the in a big screen this movie that has always been considered a beautiful film. One of the people who have written about this book, this novel book. Film has said that visually, this is a B movie render with the beauty, the visual beauty of an A film. So I'm very eager to see that. The other thing that I like this movie for is its representation of slavery. So we don't. What we have here is a sort of Freudian triangle. The terror is not the terror of monsters. It is actually the terror of legacy, of family, of slavery, of a slaveholding family that now has to come to terms with the fact that they live in a society that held slaves, that they themselves were slaveholders, that inside that family there are things that need to be reckoned with. And this is something that Sir Lancelot talks about. But it is sensitive in its treatment of slavery, it is sensitive in its treatment of voodoo. Might not be entirely accurate, but it is the best we have from this era. And I actually can't wait to see it, and I hope you guys enjoy it because it is a film that is unique in its beauty, unique in its respect, unique in its recreation of the Caribbean in a small movie set, it actually manages to convince you that you are out there in the Caribbean Sea. The way it treats light is spectacular. So I can't wait, and I hope you enjoy it. And if I can see you out there, if you have any comments, I'd love to hear from some of you afterwards as we go out. If you really like it, please like it. It's really lovely. Thank you so much.